welcome back to the Striha Sports Podcast. I'm your host, Parker Striha, and on today's episode, we are going to be discussing the situation between the Arizona Cardinals and Kyler Murray. I'm by no means professional, but I do love talking about sports, so thank you for joining me. So we're just going to jump right into it and talk about why he is upset with the Cardinals. And to put it simply, he wants more money, he wants a new contract. Now, I don't really think he's worth the money that he's going to want from the Cardinals or whatever team he is playing on in the future. That's just me. I don't really think he's done enough in the league at all to warrant getting, say, Aaron Rodgers money, because, I mean, you look at quarterbacks that signed extensions this year, Derek Carr, Matthew Stafford, Aaron Rodgers, and you look at those three and compare them to a guy like Kyler Murray, and they're just, what they've done in the league obviously isn't the same because they haven't been in the league for the same amount of time, but Rodgers has won, I believe, four MVPs, has won a Super Bowl. Matthew Stafford has won a Super Bowl. Derek Carr really hasn't done a lot, but I mean, he's not getting the money that a guy like Aaron Rodgers is, and I think Kyler Murray's going to want money in that ballpark, and I don't think he's worth it. I kind of have some stats to back that up, and I'll go over that in a little bit. But, yeah, he wants a new contract, and I think he's not going to play for the Cardinals this year unless they give him that contract. So I think it is most likely that he is going to be traded. So after I kind of go over some of these stats, I am going to be going over a couple potential trades for Kyler Murray. Some of them, I'm not really sure if they're great, but we'll kind of go over them as we get there. But after being the number one overall pick in 2019 out of Oklahoma, Kyler Murray actually has a negative career record. He does not have a record of equal to or above 500. And I mean, that's not necessarily his fault because that Cardinals team, when they picked him, wasn't great. And they had never really done anything except for this year when they started out 7-0 and then ended up going to the playoffs to get smoked. But he does have a career record of 22-23-1. And then he is 0-1 in the playoffs, and in that playoff game, he did not play well at all. Okay, so in 2021, he had 3,787 passing yards to go along with 24 passing touchdowns and 10 interceptions. He also had 423 rushing yards and 5 rushing touchdowns. So he had just over 4,000 yards and 29 total touchdowns in 14 games. That's not terrible. You'd like to see probably a touchdown to interception ratio a little bit better than 2.4, but the rushing numbers I think were good. Passing numbers weren't anything special, but there's really only so much he can do. I mean, he can't make every single play by himself, and I mean, that's kind of just how that team is. But in his 46 career games, Kyler Murray has 11,480 passing yards, 70 passing touchdowns, 34 interceptions, 1,786 rushing yards, and 20 rushing touchdowns. So he has just over 13,000 total yards to go along with 90 touchdowns. That's not terrible, but that does not warrant him getting, say, $35 to $40 million a year like he's probably going to want. And I mean, yes, he was the number one overall pick, and that might matter, or that might mean something to certain teams, like, he's the number one pick. We probably should pay him more. Otherwise, he's going to get upset here. But I don't think he's worth that money. And I'm kind of scared for any team that trades for him because I think they're most likely going to end up overpaying for him. But after that, we're just going to... Well, now that we went over that, we're just going to go over a couple potential trades. I think I only have four or five. And we'll kind of just go over each one. I'll kind of highlight what each team is getting, and then I'll explain a little bit, and we'll go from there. So, trade one. The Philadelphia Eagles are receiving Kyler Murray and a 2023 fifth-round pick, and the Arizona Cardinals are receiving Jalen Hurts, Jalen Reagor, pick 15, pick 18, pick 83 in 2022, and a 2023 first and a 2024 fourth-round pick. Now, I don't think the Eagles are sold on Jalen Hurts. I don't think he's a great quarterback. I don't think he's terrible, but I don't really think he's a franchise quarterback by any means. I think Jalen Reagor was kind of a waste of a first-round pick, especially considering They took him a pick before Justin Jefferson, which, I mean, we've kind of seen how that's panned out. And then going into the picks, pick 15 and 18, I think that's just what the Cardinals are going to require. Like, they're going to want, I mean, they might be able to get out of that with only giving up one of those first round picks, but I think it'll most likely be both of them. And then those other picks don't really matter. They're more so just roster filler picks, except for that first round pick next year. But with Hurts and Rager going to the Eagles, I think that gives them a brand new start. Jalen Hurts would have a guy like DeAndre Hopkins, who I think he would really like. Jalen Rager would hopefully, for his sake, be used a little bit better than he has been in Philadelphia. And he would probably get more touches, especially since the Cardinals lost Christian Kirk this offseason. But then for Kyler Murray going to Philly, who I think isn't necessarily more primed to compete this year, but they have the easier division to compete in. Because if the Cowboys have a down year, I think it's the Eagles' division to lose this upcoming season. And Kyler Murray would instantly, I don't know if he'd be the best quarterback in that division, because I do like Dak Prescott and I do think Dak Prescott's really good. But Kyler Murray would instantly change the landscape of the NFC East, and he would make the Eagles an even scarier team for years to come. I think he would really like Miles Sanders, Dallas Goedert, Devontae Smith. That Eagles offensive line, I think, is pretty good. That defense is all right. They have some spots or some holes that need to be filled. But overall, I think this is an even trade for both of them. I kind of just threw picks in there. I tried to look on Spotrac.com. I just kind of looked at what the Browns gave up for Deshaun Watson, and I kind of tried to do something similar for Kyler Murray, because I didn't want to have too little or too much value getting sent from one team to another, just because that's not really realistic. Moving on to the second trade, the Carolina Panthers are receiving Kyler Murray and a 2023 fifth-round pick, and the Arizona Cardinals are receiving Sam Darnold, Michael Jordan, an offensive lineman, not the NBA Hall of Famer. Number 6 in this year's draft, number 137 in this year's draft, a 2023 first and second round pick, and a 2024 first round pick. Sam Darnold is not the guy in Carolina, and I think if I'm Matt Rhule, I need to take a swing on a guy like Kyler Murray, because he could save Matt Rhule's job. Because Sam Darnold is not going to lead that team to the promised land, and I think Kyler Murray could. Put Kyler Murray with a guy like Christian McCaffrey, Terrace Marshall, Robbie Anderson, DJ Moore. I mean, if they can fix up that offensive line a little bit, that could be a really, really scary team in the NFC this year. That defense, I think, is really good. So giving Kyler Murray the keys to the offense, I think, would just elevate the ceiling of that offense to a lot higher level than it was with Sam Darnold or even Cam Newton this year. And Michael Jordan would more so just be a depth offensive lineman, kind of just a salary filler in this trade. Cardinals would get the 6th overall pick, so they could easily, if they're not sold on Sam Darnold, they could say, get out of here, they could trade him again or cut him, and they could take a guy like Malik Willis or Kenny Pickett at number 6 overall, and they wouldn't necessarily be as far back as they would with Sam Darnold. And then just, yeah, for the Cardinals, I don't really know what would happen with that. Other than what they do with those picks, I think a lot of those picks, except the first rounders, are kind of meaningless. I mean, that second round pick is pretty solid, but the 4th round pick, don't really know how much impact they'd have on the Cardinals season this year. The Pittsburgh Steelers are my 3rd trade. They receive Kyler Murray and a 2023 fifth round pick, and the Arizona Cardinals receive Mitchell Trubisky, Derek Tuska, a 2022 first round pick, which is number 20 overall, a 2022 second round pick, which is number 52 overall, a 2023 first round pick, a 2023 fourth round pick, and a 2024 first round pick. Now, out of all of the teams on this list, I think the Steelers are the closest to competing, and I think they're really just a quarterback away. I mean, rest in peace to Dwayne Haskins. I would have loved to see him compete for the starting quarterback job in Pittsburgh this year, because, I mean, with him there, I think he was the highest potential guy in that room. I'm not really sold on Mitchell Trubisky or Mason Rudolph. And I think despite them just signing Mitchell Trubisky, if they're going to trade for Kyler Murray, Trubisky's gone. He's in that trade. And he could be a solid quarterback for the Cardinals, but like with the Panthers trade and even the Eagles trade, they'd get a pick that they could easily take another quarterback with, unless they want to rock with Trubisky this year. Tuska is more of just a depth edge rusher. He could play spot snaps. He's not going to be a huge impact player, but I think he has really high upside despite not being great right now. And then the picks are kind of the picks. I don't really know what they do with those picks. They'd be really just trying to improve the roster that they have this year, or trying to improve the roster this year to compete next year, depending on what they do with that 2023 first round pick. And then the last trade, I have the Houston Texans receiving Kyler Murray and a 2023 fifth round pick, and the Arizona Cardinals receiving Davis Mills, Titus Howard, the number 3 overall pick, the number 13 overall pick, the number 35 overall pick, and then a 2023 first and third round pick. So I think this Texans trade is the best for the Cardinals. They're getting three top 35 picks in this year's draft, which is huge if they're trying to fix that roster. If Davis Mills isn't their guy, they can use that third overall pick or the 13th overall pick and get a guy like Kenny Pickett or Desmond Ridder or Malik Willis, and I don't think they'd be as far back as you may think. Titus Howard would be a solid either depth, or he could even be a starting offensive lineman for them. Davis Mills, I'm not sure what he would do. I think he would have the potential to be a starting quarterback for them. He was probably the second best rookie quarterback this past season, despite being a pick and a quarterback that no one really thought was going to do anything. And then the whole Deshaun Watson scandal stuff happened. So Davis Mills was their full-time starter. Texans, for them, they just traded Deshaun Watson. So unless they're absolutely 100% sold, Davis Mills is our guy, I think they might as well take a chance on Kyler Murray. Really good young quarterback in the league, and they'd be able to try to build their franchise around him in a way that they couldn't for Deshaun Watson. So out of all of these trades, if I'm the Arizona Cardinals, I'm probably taking either the Houston Texans or the Philadelphia Eagles trade, because with both of those, you're getting two first-round picks this year. You're getting a guy who has pretty good upside at the quarterback position, so you can either have him try to be your franchise guy, or you can draft someone this year, and then you're getting a solid depth or even potential starter at the offensive line position or wide receiver who just need a fresh start. It's clearly not working out with the team that they're on. So I think the Cardinals would be a perfect place for them to try to revitalize and reinvigorate their young careers. But as always, I'm your host, Parker Striha, and this has been the Striha Sports Podcast. Our random sport fact of the day is that the North Dakota State Bison football team has won 9 FCS national championships between 2011 and 2021. As always, thank you for tuning in, and don't forget to hit that notification bell for whenever a new video gets posted.